Well, check it out, y'all. We got what you need. We're all living in apartments, condos, vans. Well, dude, even you can have a studio. A studio in a box. Yes, we can help you with that right here at Blind Knowledge. We work on your budget, and we figure out your measurements. We'll get you the best sound for the best price. Let me know, 877-237-1143, or at blindknowledge.com. Yep!
To Maniacal Music Musings. I'm your host that you adore and have been dreaming of in your fantasy.
Bullshit.
We're at Leckinger tonight, so I can't fucking say shit about that anyway. But I'll tell you, this month's playlist has had me under pressure like a motherfucker. But it's also made me feel alive this last week. We'll get there. But it's also made me feel alive this last week.
Green Street.
That's if being alive was tied to the whipping post on a lovely day with Chancy holding the whip. Ain't nobody does it better than your motherfucking musers, as you know. We bring you that uptown funk and that superb ass. Sorry, I pronounced that wrong. I mean superb ass. Damn spelling mistakes Nicki Minaj makes, motherfuckers. But let me tell you about my famous co-host. My famous co-host is here to put the flavor in your ear for all you sucker MCs. And he may throw something else in there as well. He's a sick man. He's California dreaming for as he goes station to station looking for Gloria. His amor prohibido, even though she told him to go your own way. He's a mannish boy whose balls smell like green onions as he stands in his buffalo stance over a heavy metal drummer ever long as always. This free bird never let you enjoy the silence. Chancy motherfucking Grife in the house.
Ever long in the buffalo stance.
Hi.
Hi.
Howdy. Good to see you,
Chancy. How are ya?
How are ya?
Hey, how are ya?
The fucking 5 minute delay. The fucking 5 minute delay while he sips his soda. I fucking love it.
Brand new flavor in
you. But yes. Exactly. And we're going to get to that too soon. Your musers are back once again with the Rolling Stone bracket. That's right. The bracket where we take the top 500 Rolling Stone songs and talk about how horrible Rolling Stone is at ranking things. Welcome back. Because part three is going to be a motherfucker here. There is literally maybe two or three songs in this whole freaking bracket that I am okay with losing in the first round. So fuck me and fuck everybody else who's got to do this. We're all fucked tonight. Just saying it out first. Things first. And we have some new guests and some returning guests.
I am not.
Yes, I know some of you haven't heard the bracket yet, but guess what? It's all songs you're going to fucking know. I guarantee it. So returning for, of course, though, our good friend A.A. Ron from Yaha Podcast over this direction somewhere over here.
Boom Shanka, baby.
And, of course, returning as always on this side of me, and I got it right. Yay. Is Kasey motherfucking Bach from An Evening at the Movies and a bunch of other podcasts I'll tell you about later.
I'm your Poppy. Yes.
You can be. For some people.
I'm your Huckleberry.
Not yours.
Oh, choose my Poppy. I got Chancy. Why don't I use my Poppy? But returning, as always, of course, above me this direction is the beautiful Bubbles from Bracket Bastards, as always. Joined by her bodyguard, husband, Mr. Josh, who is joining us for the first time on this show. Glad to have a husband-wife duo on this to take on these songs. And last, but certainly not. Trouble.
Get your squeaky clean.
You done? But of course, last but not least, Mr. Freddie Fisher, the headbaster himself from Bracket Bastards, has returned to the Maniacal Music Musings for the first time in a long time, and we are glad to have him back.
It's been a freaking minute, dude. What the hell?
I know it. I know it has. It's been a minute, but you're back. So, no belly aching. And of course, folks, the order this is going to go in for voting purposes is A.A. Ron starting us off as always, because alphabetical order is a bitch. Followed by Bubbles, Chancy, Freddie, myself, Josh, and as always, Kasey brings up the rear, because don't blame me, it's what your parents named you. So, we are going to start what is going to be the most stressful couple hours of our fucking lives, I think, so far. And the first matchup is nothing to fuck with. So, A.A. Ron, the honor goes to you to start it, of course.
There's no Wu-Tang in this list.
Wu-Tang is on every fucking part of this bracket, dude.
You said nothing to fuck with.
I've been told they're for the children.
They are for the children.
And they are truly for the... They are truly the fucking
Wu-Tang for everyone, all right?
So lay it on me, man. Who we got?
Well, the first matchup is going to be a 50s versus 70s matchup. Mm-hmm. And it's number 432, Summertime Blues by Eddie Cochran from 58 versus number 414, Dreaming by Blondie from 1979.
All right. I've got Dreaming at number 12, Summertime Blues at number 9. It's going to be Summertime Blues. It's a classic. But I got to say about the Blondie track that Clem Burke is the most underrated drummer in rock, and you can tell in what this song and Atomic and a whole bunch of others.
Oh, I mean, I'll wait to my turn. I'll wait to my fucking turn. Miss Bubbles, the center of bastardism, you're up next. Is it Blondie or Eddie Cochran?
Part of me wants to say Eddie Cochran, but I'm going to go Blondie on this one.
It sounds like Cochran.
I was going to say we can call him Eddie Cochran for the rest of this if we have to, but I don't like to do that in these shows. Then it makes a freaking certain person always move forward because of the joke. So, hence why, what was it, Chancy? Hashtag Bigfoot Terry Dick got Bigfoot pretty far in the cryptids bracket back in the day. So,
oh, yeah. That was my doing.
Oh, God. I mean, I'm sorry. Shit's funny, and I'm going to make it go. I gave it the fucking legs. I'm going to make it walk. Call me Dr. fucking Frankenfuck. I don't know what to tell you.
I think I'll call you Dr. Frankenhooper. But
hashtag Dr. Frankenfuck's Harry Dick.
But Chancy, it's your turn, actually. Is it Eddie Cochran or Blondie?
Oh, it's definitely Eddie Cochran.
And this one's already a tight one for the first fucking matchup. But
Eddie Cochran.
Exactly. But Freddie, it's up to you now. And I don't know if you know both these songs, but you should.
I don't know my name. Is this the entire Dreaming, like, dreaming one?
Yeah.
That's like from way.
Dreaming.
I thought he was talking about that super oldie song.
Okay, it's not the song. The only one I can think of is the entire Summertime Blues, which ironically enough is not the one I'm actually thinking of either, but it does go into the country song from Alan Jackson. So I will not be voting for Summertime Blues because of this Summertime Blues. I'm voting for the Summertime Blues because of Alan Jackson on this one.
Okay, then.
Technically, he covered that song, so I mean, it was a rock song, and then he covered it.
Rush covered that song.
I'm pretty sure Eddie Cochran covered that song, so that's just the version they went with on this. So
the Who we'll covered that song?
It's been done a lot, and that brings it down to me. All right, who's got the background? Okay, there goes. But yeah, that brings it down to me, and
that'll be you.
I'm already dreading these fucking matchups horribly. And this one I dread somewhat. But because I want to keep it interesting for the first match of the night, I'll throw one to Blondie because both these songs are amazing songs. As much as I love Summertime Blues, it's okay, Jack. But still. That brings it down to Josh.
I reclaim my time.
I'm going to go with Blondie as well. Not so much for the song, but the artist. So
she is hot. So I'll give it to you.
But I think if I had it, if I had them side by side to do over again, I'd probably go Blondie. But in my rankings, I had Summertime Blues ahead. What the hell?
Well, Mr. Kasey, that means for the first match of the night, you get to be a tiebreaker and bring it up the rear here. Right here.
So I will be voting for the song that was covered by Brian Setzer in a little biopic called The Bomba. Summertime Blues. Thank you.
Yep. Ooh. Which means Summertime Blues does, in this wintertime we're in, get moved into the second round. Will they make it past the second round? I don't fucking know. I honestly don't know who's going to win the next one even. It's going to be another tough one. And Bubbles, if she is back on screen, she is not.
Almost. She'll be here in like seconds.
Well, ten. Seconds were
nine.
One eight, Mississippi.
Seven. Six. Five. Four.
Mississippi.
Three and two three, and one.
Mississippi.
Two.
I don't understand.
Good girl.
Why are we counting?
For you.
Oh, what's the matchup?
You're up.
What's the matchup? Bubbles, you're starting this one. And it's an 80s versus 60s matchup. We're jumping decades here like a motherfucker. It's number 431, Adore by Prince from 87, versus number 413, Gloria by Them from 1964.
Oh, I'm going to go with Prince.
Yeah. That's actually why I'm at. Oh, I don't know. We'll see. We'll see how this goes. But Chancy, yes, it's rapper. Up to you now, buddy.
Yep.
And that's a big fat yup, as I expected. But Freddie, is it Adore by Prince or Gloria by Them? And holy crap, I see Freddie finally.
Fuck Prince.
Whoa.
That's a good thing Amanda didn't make it on this episode, because she would kill you.
Most likely. Most likely. But that brings it down to me. And while I will not ever say those horrible words about Prince that Freddie just did, Adore is not one of his better songs, in my opinion. So I much prefer listening to Gloria. That song is classic and it's fucking incredible. Everything about that song is fucking incredible. And it's got that 60s.
Adore vibe. Or Gloria? No, Gloria.
Gloria. But that means it's all tied up. Josh, which way you want to go, Prince or Them?
Same thing as last time. I'm going to go with the artist, not the song, so I'm going with Prince.
All right. And Kasey.
Yeah, this matchup's over. Move Prince on to the next round, please.
Which means Prince
will move on to the next round. I am not incurring the wrath of my co-host.
I don't blame you. She's scary when she's got a shank. But that means Prince will be moved on to the next round.
He's even scarier when Oklahoma loses.
Oh, yes. I've seen those messages. Woo-hoo. But that means that Prince will move on to face A. Cochran in round two. But A. Ron, which way would you have voted?
You could burn up my clothes, smash up my ride. Well, maybe not the ride. I'm going with Adore, Prince.
Yeah, I knew that one wasn't in your top five, but I had figured I knew you were a Prince fan to some degree.
Adore was number 15, Gloria number 18.
All right. Which means Sir Chancelot gets to start off the next matchup. And this might actually be one of the closest matchups we have, because it's only a 4-year difference between these two songs. But, and there might be another meltdown by Chancy in this one, I'm just saying.
Closest in terms of being contemporaneous to one another?
Yes.
Okay. Are you going to mispronounce the name of the singer?
Maybe. Just maybe. We'll find out. But the matchup is going to be, Chancy, number 430, They Reminisce Over You, or Troy by Pete Rock and CL Smooth from 92, or number 412, Buffalo Stance by Nina Cherry from 88.
What was the name of the first one again?
They Reminisce Over You or Troy.
And the name of the second one again?
Buffalo Stance.
Buffalo Stance is the second one.
I know you're being a dick, Chancy. I know you are. I already know.
They Reminisced Over You, T period, R period, O period, Y period. We're acronyming.
Fuck it. We'll go with Troy.
I mean, the fucking Grease did, so why not? But, Freddie, is it Reminisced Over You or Buffalo Stance?
So, I'm going to... In repentance of my parents' sins of that I've done to Chancy, in the bracket that we're doing on bracketology, I'm going to give him my vote on this one, and I think I will give him a total of 5 votes that I will give him throughout the time that I am here.
What the fuck is this nonsense?
So Chancy will be taking my vote on this one that I'm giving. I am not going to be giving him the choice on
stack up, the one he gets
to pick. I will give it to him because I don't care. I don't know either one of these songs.
Yeah, I'm not too familiar with them either. So
I heard he gets the one, and he's already used those 5. Well, does he have to go opposite on the other ones?
Oh, I mean, it's up to you guys.
Yeah, I guess you could let... Well, Chancy already picked one, didn't he? He picked Troy.
Yeah, so he did.
Troy.
So, Frey's going with Troy as well, so...
I guess you could just say yup. You could give him 5 yups.
Yeah, well, but I'm going to let him know.
The question is, Freddie, though, whoever's got music playing in the background, please shut it off before we get taken off YouTube again for having...
I'm in a bar.
But the question is, Freddie, does Chancy get to pick what matches the 4 other votes go on?
No, he said. He said no.
Oh. All right. Well, that would have made it a little more interesting. But I'm next up on this matchup, and I didn't think I knew either of these songs. But as soon as They Reminisce Over You came on, I was taken back to the young days of a young man in high school. Turning on NBA Street Volume 2, and that is the fucking song that plays as soon as that game starts. The fucking sax starts playing when the title screen comes on. It's fucking incredible.
I did like that sax.
And, I mean, Pete Rock and CL Smooth are fucking classic, amazing rappers that are legends by this point. I haven't heard of Nina Cherry, if that is how you say her name even. I don't know. I almost wanted to say Nay Nay just to piss Chancy off. But, Buffalo Stance actually grew on me listening to this playlist all week. It really did grow on me. But what the fuck is a Buffalo Stance? Does it literally mean getting on all fours, like a fucking doggy style type thing? Or like, I want to know what the fuck a Buffalo Stance is.
Do not know. Buffalo
stand on 4 legs. So I'm imagining it's getting on all fours. This is just my mind all week trying to figure out what the fuck a Buffalo Stance is. But I have to give it to They Reminisce Over You regardless, because it's just... classic, pure classic. I mean, out of all the rap songs on this bracket, They Reminisce is the best one by far.
Okay, so
to stand with your arms crossed looking sideways is the Buffalo Stance.
Oh, is that what that is? Because I was going to say, since Jeremy opened the door, my immediate thought went to when they're those memes when they're all like, oh, I know how to take it from the back, and it shows them all arch back, like, you know, a buffalo has that arch in their back. I was like, oh, I mean, I guess in some weird fucking way. What the fuck just happened? It looks like we just invaded another country up there. What are you doing, Senator? Invading the fucking, invading the kingdom of Minoria?
I did not know that Nina
Cherry humans are invading us.
Oh, so you're repelling the invaders. Fucking understandable.
Jesus Christ, dude.
That's fucking awesome.
That means that Kasey gets to choose now. Is They Reminisce Over You moving on, or is Buffalo Stance getting a vote?
I will be voting with one third of a upcoming announcement on An Evening at the Movies, Mr. Chancy Greif.
So that's a yup.
I believe that's a yup, yeah. I took me a second there. I was like, what the fuck is one third of Eating at the Movies? What? But yeah.
You okay, don't worry about it until February 10th.
Oh, I saw that post. So, yeah. But no, you that didn't. Means they
I haven't made that announcement yet.
Okay, then, Spanky. But that means Troy is moving on. But Mr. Josh, what was your vote?
I think they went and boned down. They'll be back.
Yeah, they're repelling the foreign horde.
Or they're making more of the foreign horde. We don't know. But Aaron,
that's kind of how it works. You know,
they're increasing the domestic horde right now.
If you got to go to Pound Town, you do it when you got to do it.
Yeah. I agree with Jeremy in that the more I heard the Nina Cherry song, the more it moved up. But it kind of slid around for me when I did my final rankings today. It ended up at number 30, and Troy is number 27. So I went with Troy. It has kind of Tribe Called Quest vibes. I like that.
I trust no war crimes were committed in this repelling of the foreign horde.
I thought they were boning down.
I said I trust no war crimes were committed in the repelling of the foreign horde.
Oh my god, almost. Okay, so they're fucking around to find out. So
hold on.
We have three of them right now and they are just out of control.
You're gonna have to advise. You're gonna have to hire me to be your political advisor, because the proper response for that is I can neither confirm nor deny any current military engagements.
Fair enough.
Willful wrongdoing.
It is Josh.
Josh picks the Troy as well.
Josh picks Troy. Okay.
Yeah. What do you pick, Bubbles?
Can Chancy?
I'm gonna pick. Well, I have a question real
quick. Can Chancy be a political advisor if he's already a vice president?
I'm the president. Yeah. I'm the presidential candidate.
Sorry. Vice president should inherently
be a political advisor. Yes, because nobody's gonna want to shoot Chancy to have Harvey be president. So that's why Chancy's the president. That's the whole logic behind that. Motive there, but
damn. So the correct
I will be writing in
the actual response on that is I can technically be a political advisor until the actual race begins, because then it becomes a conflict of interest. it's like somebody having to, like, you know, step down from their position in order to
stepping down from the Buffalo stance.
Yeah. Yes,
exactly. Right. So, with a hump on the shoulder. That means they reminisce over you, moves on in our first. What is that called, Chancy?
It's a sweep
of the night.
Oh, wow.
And that means that Mr. Freddie gets to start off the next one.
Yeah, Cherry deserved better.
Yo, I agree. And I will put her in between one of the rounds for this episode when it releases the podcast for him. No worries, because I gotta look more into her, because I actually like her music. So, because let me introduce the hi-hat.
That's cool.
But Freddie, the match you're starting up has a 30-year fucking difference between the songs. It's 80s versus 2000s. And it's number 429, Under Pressure by Queen and David Bowie from 81, versus number 411, Heavy Metal Drummer by Wilco from 2001.
It's gotta be Under Pressure. That's
20 years.
I mean, that's a roller skating rink type song for me right there. And then, of course, it reminds me of fucking Vanilla Ice as well. So, like, that's like a triple feature right there. It's definitely Under Pressure for me.
See, this is one of those ones I don't mind this one song losing in the first round since it's my turn next. This one song, I mean, heavy metal drummer, it's a classic. Like, she fell in love with the drummer. Like, yeah, I was a drummer. I get that. But I 100%, I didn't even know heavy metal. God, no. But I'm 100% going to go with Under Pressure as well because it's fucking Queen. It's fucking Queen. And it's better than that gayest music video that David Bowie and Mick Jagger did for Dancing in the Streets. So it's the better of the two David Bowie collaborations in this fucking shit. But Josh, is it Under Pressure or Heavy Metal Drummer?
Under Pressure. Oh, yeah. Absolutely. It's like the first song out of all of these that I've actually known, like, legitimately.
No, trust me, you would know Heavy Metal Drummer if you heard it. I think you're around the same age as me, so you would definitely know.
At least by name.
I heard it for the first time today.
I mean, I've been listening to this fucking playlist for a week straight, so because we had no regular episode of Musers this week, so a week straight listening to this playlist, sure. I've heard it like 6 times now, and it's just, I know every song by fucking heart.
I heard it for the first time 2 days ago when I listened to the playlist for the first time.
But Kasey, is Under Pressure moving on, or is it going to be Heavy Metal Drummer?
1981 to 2001 is 20 years, sir. But yes.
How dare you question my math?
I had it on mute, just waiting for it to be my turn. Kasey, I want you to know, you fucked yourself out of a meltdown, sir. I was waiting for it too. I was like, if nobody's gonna fucking say this, damn, I swear it to God, I'm gonna be the one to do it. I'm gonna fucking do it.
Well, I mean, you can still do it if you want. Just rip that fucking band-aid right
now. Yeah, rage against the dying of the light, Chancy.
And that's a clip, but thank you. But Kasey, which way are you going to go?
Under Pressure.
Which means Under Pressure will face They Reminisce Over You in the next round. And I dread that matchup with a lot. But AA Ron, which way you want to go?
You know, every time it gets to me, it's already been fucking decided tonight.
you'll be going up first.
I had these two close together. Because as much as I love Queen and David Bowie, I think it's the stupidest song that either one of them ever did, almost. People in the Streets. What the fuck is that bit about?
Better than Dancing in the Streets.
I love Dancing in the Streets. I love six different groups' versions of Dancing in the Streets. The Grateful Dead do Dancing in the Streets.
Of course, that's why you love it, because it's Grateful Dead.
But I went with Under Pressure, number 22, versus Heavy Metal Drummer, which I thought was really good. I'd never heard it before.
Oh, it's...
And it's
been... It was in a couple 2000s movies, yeah. So that's why I know it.
Every time I hear Wilco, I like them, but I've never really taken the time to dive into them. It's that sort of thing.
Well...
But they were close.
Senator Bubbles for Dexterity version. Which way are you going to go?
Dexterity.
I feel like if you vote against Queen, it's like almost a sin.
For ambidexterity.
We're definitely going Under Pressure.
Well, the people on Master Bears don't fucking agree when they voted for fucking Freddie Mercury to win second in the Best Singer Ever competition to Whitney.
Calm
fucking
him down
Houston.
With a bubble pop, please.
Motherfuckers! That still pisses me off to this day. No disrespect to Whitney Houston.
That is a gimmick infringement.
No disrespect to Whitney fucking Houston, but it's Freddie fucking Mercury.
He didn't give you an in.
Sanctions. Sanctions.
Fuck sanctions. Followed by Elton John in second. I'm sorry. I'm not sorry. But Chancy, finish us out. Is it another sweep? Are we going to have a sweep in the second round?
Yes. Yes, we shall.
Fucking sweeps of sweeps. Holy motherfucking shit. But...
I literally ripped myself off of a Chancy meltdown for a Jeremy meltdown. What the fuck?
Yeah. Oh, wait till we get to
Puppet Master, buddy.
Wait till we get to Puppet Master. Wait till we get to fucking Puppet Master. The next matchup gets started by me. And it's 60s versus 2010s in what might be one of the longest apart matchups we have. And it's 70 number years. 428.
People in the Street.
It's number 428, Sign of the Times by Harry Styles from 2017, versus number 410, Whipping Post by the Allman Brothers Band from 1969. And while I have never liked Harry Styles in my fucking life, this song fucking grew on me over the week. It fucking grew on me. It just fucking grew on me. However, it doesn't have the amazing fucking riff that opens up Whipping Post. So, of course, I have to go Whipping Post, because I'm pretty sure my dad's band played that when they did gigs. So, 100% Whipping Post. I love that fucking riff from the beginning. And every man knows what it's like to feel like you're attached to the Whipping Post.
Is that an 11-4 time?
Yes. And especially if you're fucking married, you know what it's like to be tied to Whipping Post. So, if your marriage is done right or done wrong, pick a direction. I don't really care. But, Kasey, which way you want to go?
Some people pay good money for that. I'm just letting you know.
Oh, Vanessa's told me. But which way you want to go?
I am not next in the boat. Next up would be...
Josh! I'm sorry, man. No, actually, yeah, it would be Mr. Bubbles, which I should fucking know, because that's my brother's name.
Keep going near the mic, or does this mic pick it up? It picks it up just fine. I keep doing this just because you're doing this, so I feel like I'm playing Monkey See, Monkey Do. But I'm going to go with Harry Styles. I'm not going to lean to the mic anymore. I thought I had to. I thought it was just like our exercise.
No, we hear you. You're fine.
In all fairness, your wife and her sister both hold the mic to their mouth, like, and it looks like it's a little vibrator, and for the longest time we thought it was.
But well, she needs to get really close to do her little bubble pop.
Yeah.
I think that was Aaron asking for a pop, but now there you go.
There we go.
She went cheeky on us.
Bubble pop only fans coming soon.
Bubble pop.
But Mr. Kasey, which way do you want to go, sir? Harry Styles or Allman Brothers? All tied up at the moment.
I'll go Whipping Post.
No comment. And Aaron, how about you, sir?
Well, I think you already know the answer to this one, because I told you my number one.
Yes.
First time I heard Sign of the Times as well, but I liked it. But Whipping Post is the magnum opus of the Allman Brothers Band. It's that and Layla are Duane Allman's two greatest accomplishments. And Frank Zappa kind of took ownership of the tune. One time in Helsinki in 1974, years after Duane Allman was dead, it was time for an encore, and somebody yelled Whipping Post, and Frank didn't know Whipping Post. And he's like, I wish we knew it. It'd be cool. So, you want Whipping Post? Here we go. And then he ended up going out learning Whipping Post, and they played it in pretty much every encore for the rest of the time that he toured. So well, I'm a huge Whipping Post fan.
I've seen your wife, so compliments to you, sir. But
righty then.
But Bubbles, is Whipping Post moving on, or is Harry Styles getting another vote? Because I honestly could see you going either way in this.
I like to go both ways, but on this one, I am picking Harry Styles.
One, color me not surprised. Two, you're voting with your pants once again. We go through some bastards enough. And three, I love that your husband's face expression didn't change when you said that at all. So I fucking love it.
I just now realized that that's kind of a play on the word hairstyle.
I never thought of that, but that's fucking genius, Aaron. And Chancy, is Allman Brothers moving on, or are you tying it up for Freddie?
No, the Allman Brothers are moving on.
No emotion at all. Just Harry Styles can go fuck himself, according to Chancy, but. But Freddie, for dexterity purposes, which way would you have gone?
For dexterity purposes, I was going to give my vote Chancy on this one, because to be perfectly honest, I don't recognize either one of these songs.
You would know Sign of the Times if you fucking heard it. I know you would.
I probably would, but the problem is that I dove into this last minute, So I didn't get a chance to listen to the list. So this is coin number two going to Chancy. So I'm going to second Chancy's vote on this one.
All right, which means Almond Brothers moves on 5-2. And we'll be facing one of these two, started by Josh. And, oh, Josh, you'll know these songs, I'm pretty damn sure. It's 17 years apart, 80s versus 90s. It's number 427, Rapper's Delight by Sugar Hill Gang from 1980 versus number 409, Everlong by Foo Fighters from 97. Ooh. And there's meltdowns coming. I already know it.
Damn, the old me wants to hip hop, but you don't stop the
rocking to the bang bang boogie. Say
the new me kind of wants to roll with the Foo Fighters. This is a fucking tough one. Is this the same as the bright, like fuck you, Jeremy, or fuck you as the fucking
On this show, we allow fuck you phrase as well. They all get added.
Okay, we'll just throw that out there because this is a conundrum for me.
Yeah, that's why I pre-rank them so I don't have to feel the pain.
Dave Grohl, I'm going to go off of character alone. Dave Grohl is a badass. He's an awesome dude. So I'm going to go with the Foo Fighters.
And Kasey, I saw your face when I said the matchup, so I'm dying to hear what you're going to go with.
I will not, in good conscience, ever vote against the drummer from the band that started in my hometown.
Are you going to do the come as you are thing? Let's hear the come as you are story, man. Let's hear it. I want to hear it.
He's been sick for a week, but I kind of want to hear what the hashtag's up to.
I want to hear it twice.
Hey, want to hear it twice?
No.
Well, then we better vote once. This song through to the next round. Because, see, Come As You Are is the song that plays in the car stereo when I roll up at the freaking house party.
Mm-hmm.
So, I don't remember.
So you're voting for Everlong.
Yeah.
Yes, I will be voting for Dave slash. All right.
Those dots are connected.
Nirvana slash Foo Fighters slash. Yeah. Always and brag, forever. Kurt, long live Dave.
Butter on my breakfast toast.
Because one, Kasey's still pissed about the Nirvana losing to Weezer in the first part of this, lost to Buddy Holly, his night starts with "Come as You Are," but it ends with Everlong.
As you were.
Matter of fact, I believe Josh's wife had something to do with "Come as You Are" getting voted out in the first part of this bracket too. Just saying.
Trying to start marital problems. That's fucked.
Bubble.
But
can neither confirm nor deny.
That's the answer.
I can neither confirm nor deny these allegations.
You know,
well said, well spoken.
I do not recall.
I gotta say, Bubbles, you are the hottest Darth Vader I've ever seen, and Chancy's a good Emperor Palpatine. But which way you want to go, Aaron?
Well, it's been revealed now the last of my top five.
The last of your top five.
Can't satisfy you with this little worm, but I can bust you out with my super sperm. It's got to be the Sugar Hill Gang, number four, versus Foo Fighters, number 23. I mean, it's not even close.
It's created
hip hop. Not to mention that the embedded homophobia and misogyny therein. But well, it's a great song. I love it.
I remember in sixth grade
when it came out. The first time I heard it was out of, can't remember his last name, Eddie. I want to say Collins. Kid in sixth grade. I never heard him say a word probably before. And he's just, "I am Wonder Mike, and I'd like to say hello." He just went on and on and on. And it was like two more days before I actually heard it on the radio. But it's Rapper's Delight.
I mean, kind of be surprised, but I didn't think any rap song would be in your top five. And I honestly thought you'd have a higher rank for Foo Fighters for fucking sure. I thought it'd be top 10 at least. But
I'm lukewarm on the Foo Fighters. I love the first album, the debut album, where Dave Grohl played all the instruments.
I mean, I like Learning to Fly. That's my Foo Fighters song.
All the instruments except the one where the guy from Afghan Whigs sat in, Greg Dooley.
But Bubbles, which way you want to go? Are you going to tie it up or are you going to give it to Foo Fighters?
Anybody that's voting against Super Sperm has to be reckoned with.
Well, she has multiple kids, so she already experienced Super Sperm, I'm pretty sure.
I mean, the macaroni's soggy, the peas are mush, and the chicken tastes like wood. This is where Throw Your Hands in the Air came from, for Christ's sake.
I just want you to keep going. Like,
party hardy like you just don't care. Yeah, let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it. Do it. Do it. I'm here. I'm there. I'm Big Bank Hank. I'm everywhere. So throw your hands up in the air. Party hardy like you just don't care.
Like,
what's that?
But I'm going to have to vote for that.
All right, there you go.
You have convinced election, me. I was going to go Food
it's
Fighters.
It's voter fraud. But... it's election tampering.
Did you just call it Food Fighters?
No, I said Food.
Food Fighters.
I said food.
It's recorded.
No.
I might
food fighters is what we watch every time Bubbles is on a bracket because she fights between different foods in front of her always. Pizza, animal, whatever the fuck it be. But Chancy, it's all tied up. Which way are you going to go? Meltdown and coming.
Man, he's very chill. Looking at
I
ceiling.
Feel it.
I see the bottom of his beard.
Coming.
That's a weird sight. There is serious emotional connection for me with Everlong.
Yeah. You like to be Everlong in the Buffalo
State.
Having said that.
Do it. Let's do it. Do it.
Motel, hotel, holiday.
What you gonna do today?
Say what? I gotta do it, dude. I can't vote against Rapper's Delight. It hurts. It hurts me deep.
Holiday Inn.
If your girl gets mad or if your girl gets lippy, then you just take her friend.
Well, we've all done that, Chancy, in our worst days,
God, that hurts.
It does, but Mr. Freddie, is it Rapper's Delight or Everlong by Foo Fighters? Are you tying it up for me?
You gotta also give props to Le Chic, Freak Out, which is where the whole bass line came from that they ripped off for this. And yes, it went to court and they ended up getting a songwriting credit. I forget the guys, Nile Rodgers and one other member of Le Chic.
You guys know my love for movies, and Rapper's Delight has one of the best scenes in a movie ever.
Yep.
In The Wedding Singer, with that little old fucking lady doing hip hop, hippity hippity hip hip hop, and that will always be stuck in my head, and it gets my fucking vote just for that moment. It's Rapper's Delight for me.
That means that in a battle of the genres in round two, it'll be Allman Brothers versus Sugar Hill Gang. But to finish this out the right way, dexterously prosed, I will go and throw one more to Foo Fighters because I love both these songs. And this is for my wife because she loves Everlong more than anything in the world and she doesn't really like rap at all. So I will give it to Foo Fighters for that reason because it doesn't matter at this point.
What's her take on Super Sperm?
She gets it regularly, so she's good, trust me. But actually,
go by the name Lois Lane.
I mean, I've called her many names in the bedroom.
See your boyfriend. You can see my boyfriend, you surely can. Wonderful.
I mean, I have
called Superman.
I have like
when the homophobia comes in. He's a fairy, do you suppose? Flying through the air in pantyhose. He may be sexy or even cute, but he looks like a sucker in a blue and red suit.
I think Aaron just fucking showed a new side to himself tonight, and I love it. But the next matchup is going to get started by Kasey. You finally get to start one. And it's 40 years difference. number 426, Super Bass. I don't know why I keep wanting to say Bass. Super Bass by Nicki Minaj from 2010.
Super Bass?
Super Bass, yes. It's Nicki Minaj. It should be Super Bass. But versus number 408, Father and Son by Cat Stevens and Yusuf.
It was just Cat then.
I don't think so.
I am continuing this appearance on this show under protest because you rap bastard did it to me again. Thank you very much.
Father and Son versus Super Bass is tearing you apart.
No.
I mean, Super Bass.
Travesty that is fucking Dave Grohl being out in the first round like Kurt was two fucking brackets ago.
Yeah.
Well. Nikki.
I mean, that Super Bass will get all the votes, I'm sure. But, and I mean,
it's not going to get them all. Spoiler alert.
I'm sure with you. I'm sure with you. But, I mean, Kasey has been getting the Super Bass now for 2 months. So, you know, it's all good. But, Aaron, which way are you going to go?
1,221 times.
Yeah, oh, number... hashtag 1221, folks. It's a new number.
All right.
But Aaron, continue.
That's a masturbation count, right?
Oh, burn.
Oh, I thought that's really what it was. I'm sorry. What's no, it's moonspeak? What's moonspeak? I don't know.
I don't know what that moon, is. Baby.
Chancy, Elaine, that's what moonspeak is.
Yep.
I do not recall.
All right, Senator. So anyway, Cat Stevens, I got him number 3. Father and Son's a great song, and it was sort of stolen by my beloved Flaming Lips. Fight Test has the same chords and rhythm and everything. It's the first song on Yoshimi Battles the Pink Robots. And it ended up going to court, and they had to give Cat Stevens like 75% of the royalties on that song. But Wayne Coyne said he's proud to be forever linked to Cat Stevens, even if it's in such an embarrassing manner. But yeah, Father and Son. I'd vote Fight Test ahead of it too.
And Senator Bubbles, you're up next. It's all tied up. Is it Nicki Minaj or Cat Stevens? And I feel like I don't even have to ask, but I want to hear it anyway.
So,
Nicki Minaj,
my son absolutely loves Nicki Minaj. Like, he is almost stalkerish, kind of obsessed, kind of loves Nicki Minaj. Like, he will, like, talk about her and, like, her family as if they go and do barbecues together. So I can't, like, vote against her at all through the time that we have her on here. So
you're going Superb Ass.
Yeah, Superb Ass is...
Well, I mean, you can ask Josh, but say the senator knows about Superb Ass.
I don't know. Bend over, Josh. Let's check you out. Stand up. Do a 360.
No, you too.
Oh, me?
Yeah.
She knows it's Superb Ass. We got it. Oh, yeah. It's nice. Start twerking? It's a nice pooper there, Mr. Senator.
That's my pooper.
I mean, the senator does have a few paddles in her collection, so we all know things get freaky up in that house. But, and your son is going to be an ass man, just saying. But, Chancy, which way you want to go?
Did you name him Cosmo by chance? Cosmo, nope. Kramer, the ass man.
Fucking love it, Aaron.
I'm gonna go with Cat Stevens on this one.
Ooh, keeping it tied up, going to Freddie.
Right on, Cosmo.
Is there a Freddie in the building? All right. I'm guessing Freddie's dropping off a delivery right now. Oh, shit. That's awesome.
Hold on a second.
Ass man.
That is awesome.
We can see it. Oh, we can see it. Ass man. Fuck it. Oh. With who you're married to, sir, I don't blame you for having that. But I never.
No, we got to see them touch butts. No. Let's continue.
Souls meet where the holes meet.
Yeah, that's OnlyFans content. The souls meet where the holes meet.
Where the holes meet or something.
Oh, I mean, that's true as that may be.
That was on a movie with
Chancy Zac Efron
and Adam Devine. It was like my sister's wedding or something. Or no, somebody needs dates for a wedding.
Yeah, Dave and somebody needs a wedding.
There we go.
Yeah, I remember that movie. I can't tell you the title of it though.
But I mean, I never listened to either of these songs before this bracket, and they both kind of grew on me with this bracket. But Father and Son makes me think of my son, and that song really fucking grew on me. So I'm going with Cat Stevens because. I never thought in my life I'd vote for Nicki Minaj, and I'm still not going to. So, yeah. But, Mr. Freddie, are you back yet or no?
Damn. Like a Dungeon Dragon, he takes down Nicki Minaj.
Not yet, I didn't. But, Josh, which way you want to go, Nicki Minaj or Cat Stevens?
Okay, so, as Jess said, between a father and son, I have to go with Nicki Minaj because he sits around and he raps Nicki all day long. Every song, every release, every tour, every
Speed Up All Night for any her of it. Most recent album.
Yep. Waiting for her concert tickets to release. Everything. Knows everything about her stalker. If she ever ends up missing, I fully expect the FBI to be at my door. Like, Nicki, if you ever see this, I'm warning you, be careful. He's an adorable boy. His name is Achilles, not Cosmo. But
he's clearly an ass man.
Yeah, he is definitely that. He is all about that ass.
All about that super bass. Okay.
Super, all about bass. That super bass.
So I'm going to go with Nicki on this one for him as father and son. Sorry, Cat Stevens, but this is the father and son.
He's all about that bass, no trouble. But Freddie, you are the tiebreaker. You are the tiebreaker between.
It is actually letting me on this time because I've been talking the entire time and it's not really letting me on.
We hear you.
Okay. Is the little thing kept flashing on me, and I'm like, what the fuck? It's not letting me talk. I'm going to talk to Bubbles real quick.
You squared his beard for a minute, but you're back.
She was saying that she's a huge Marvel fan and everything else. Did not mention this. Father and Son is one of the capillary songs in the second Guardians movie.
That's true.
It is.
Yes, it's like the basis of the entire fucking movie, but nobody says that. So, yes, I am going... As a Marvel fan, I've voting all for Father and Son.
Yeah, but it's not the soundtrack that does it for me.
Well, you can blame Freddie. He's the one who killed Nicki Minaj because he was tiebreaker and Cassie.
I'm all right. It's
okay.
I don't even like Nicki.
We had an obligation
just for him.
Yeah, sure, sure.
I hate her voice. I hate everything. I don't think she's even a good rapper.
I don't mind her. I think she definitely has some songs that I can bop to in the car. Like if it comes on the radio, sometimes I'm just like, yeah, totally. Sorry. I don't like that new Barbie song.
None of them.
Oh shoot! How was the Barbie movie, Freddie? Because I still haven't seen it.
I haven't finished it yet. I had a 2.5 hour long interview today with Sharon.
I can see how that would happen. But
it's a fucking blast, and I don't know how I'm gonna edit down past 2 hours. It was a good conversation. That is gonna be my last vote for tonight, guys. It's been a pleasure. One of these nights when I'm actually planning on doing this, I would absolutely love to join you guys again. But unfortunately, I have to be at work at 5 a.m.
Got the hard out.
Freddie, give me your outro before you go.
I am Freddie Fisher. You can find me at that on Facebook. While on Facebook, check out Bracketology. We have two polls going up every single day. Currently, it is a the Kelly Renee bracket. I can't call it a Thrillers bracket anymore because I do agree that not all of those are Thrillers. And a Tom Hanks bracket, which is actually coming to a close pretty soon. On Twitter, I'm at Fisher777. You can find us all at BracketPod, and on Instagram at Can't Lick Me, not one word. Have a good day, guys.
Thank you, Freddie. We appreciate it. And we'll manage until we find a replacement for Freddie at this point.
Can't lick him.
Which, Kasey, I messaged your co-host with the link if you want to try to convince her. But
Eric, I messaged her, and I messaged Harvey, and I messaged Greg.
All right. Ah, there you go. Thank you. But that's okay, because Aaron, we're back at the top. You get to start out the first play-in matchup to see what will go into the last matchup of this side of round one. And it's fuck. It's a 23-year difference in a complete genre matchup, which I am excited for on this one. It's number 424, No Diggity by Blackstreet, featuring Dr. Dre and Queen Penn from 96, versus number 407, Free Bird by Lynyrd Skynyrd from 1973.
Okay. I have two things I want to bring up first. What's number 420?
We'll get to it on the other side of the fucking bracket. Don't worry about it yet.
All right. The other thing, we found my last place ranking. So curiously, my ranking.
You're either about to piss me off or make me really happy. Choose your words carefully.
All right. my rankings are bookended by Southern Rock. I have Whipping Post number one and Free Bird last place.
Thank you.
I like the way you work it. No Diggity. Number 14 versus number 34.
Thank you, fucking God. If you put No Diggity in last place, I was about to fucking lose my mind. But Bubbles, No Diggity, girl, what's your vote?
I hate Lynyrd Skynyrd.
Really? See, and I like Lynyrd Skynyrd, but I think that's more of like a product of my raising. Like, that's definitely like my dad's kind of music.
I grew up with it.
But that's definitely not my favorite Lynyrd Skynyrd song. So I am going to go with No Diggity because I happen to love that song. And I bopped to it.
I can picture you dancing in middle school to it, and it brings me joy. Okay.
I remember being a grown-ass man in Encino when that came out.
Of course you do, you vampire. But yeah, for those who don't know, Aaron is a vampire because he looks like he's in his 20s, but he's not. So, yeah.
but he's not. I like how you kind of like edited yourself. Thank you.
55.
Oh, wow. Like, that's, yeah, I did not see vampire-ish. That one. Vampire. Hands down.
See? Chancy's Kasey called it right. Fucking vampire. But Chancy, which way are you going to go?
It's red wine.
Yep, red wine. This is blood. But Chancy, is it No Diggity or Freebird?
I think I'll throw on to Freebird. I do love No Diggity, but I'm going to show a little love to Freebird.
Well, that means that it comes down to me next. And personally, I can't. I'm not going to say I can't stand Lynyrd Skynyrd, but Freebird, they refuse to play the concerts anymore, or at least they did, because it was such a requested song, and I've heard it so many fucking times in my fucking life that I am just... But, yeah, so I will gladly give it to No Diggity, because I fell in love with it during one of the Bastards music brackets. I think it was 90s when we did 90s. Like, I fell in love with that song. So, and it's Dr. fucking Dre. Who the fuck doesn't like Dr. Dre?
I don't think I even knew Dr. Dre was in that song until
he mainly produced it, but he had a verse in it.
Yeah, I did hear a verse or two after I saw his name. I listened for him.
But I mean, I don't know.
Man, that's back when I used a car stereo. I used a radio instead of an iPod or phone.
You still use an iPod? I have other questions, but
I do have an iPod actually. Yeah, it's my hiking music.
Like, is it touch, like an but... iPod Nano or like is it like iPod Brick?
It's like really it's like an it's like the iPhone 5 version of iPod Touch.
Okay.
Just got a new screen and battery.
Well, I think they're phasing out iPhones. Josh, which way are you going to go? Freebird or is No Diggity taking its place?
I was in, I believe, seventh grade when this song came out. Mm-hmm. And I remember, like what Aaron was saying, I was waiting by the radio station with a cassette in the player ready to push play record at the same time. That's how I got good at these two fingers, like pushing at the same time. You know?
I did that in the 70s.
Shorty, get down, good Lord. Baby got them open all over town. That's where we're going. No Diggity. Well,
No Diggity.
That means No Diggity does go into the next round. But Kasey, which way would you have gone? Or, I mean, it goes in round one, I should say. But yeah.
And how old were you when it came out?
I was 8 when it came out, so I had no idea it existed. Hey, Mooski.
I was in LA already, so I had to be like 23, 20. Oh, I was living in Encino. It would have been like 94, 93, 94.
I will back up the horror guru himself, Chancy Greif, and vote Freebird.
Well, that means...
Hi, little one.
That means that either Aaron. Oh, I know. Aaron already.
Yeah, I voted first. Aaron,
oh, so actually, that means no Diggity already won. What the fuck am I talking about?
There's a little girl there, man.
Well, she shouldn't be on podcast, but.
don't discourage that. Hi.
Hey, I do discourage that because DCF looks down on, apparently. Thank you. But...
It's time to go watch Bluey or something, though.
Oh, I wish Freddie was still on when you said that because he freaking loves that show like a passion. But,
well, okay. Safety kid at home. Okay, well, I don't think that does us any good here. Mommy, can
you help me? But that means No Diggity moves into the first round, and
that's the way it's working.
That means that Bubbles gets to start this one out, and this one's gonna piss off Chancy in no degree. I already know. But the first matchup is, I mean, well, the matchup for this one, the last matchup in round one, in this half of round one, is number 425, Mannish Boy by Muddy Waters from 1955 versus number 424, No Diggity by Blackstreet featuring Dr. Dre and Queen Penn from 1996. So we got a 41-year difference on this fucking matchup.
Well, it depends on the release of Mannish Boy because he kept re-recording it. But yeah,
right.
I went by the original recording date, so
I had the Hard Again, the 77 release. But yeah, he released it long before that.
I don't think I know that song, so I am gonna go with No Diggity.
Oh, wow. I mean, if you actually looked it up, you would know it in a second as soon as you heard the fucking opening.
Give us a little ditty.
Yeah. I need an example.
Aaron, open it up. I mean, you open it up, not the actual song, because I don't want to get taken off YouTube again.
Can't we, if I sing it, a disclaimer, like we don't own the rights to this
if
music?
If I sing it, do you get taken off of YouTube? Or if I play
okay,
it?
Aaron, just play it. We do not own the rights to this song. We are playing it so people know what the fuck we're talking about. I wasn't gonna play it out loud.
I was just gonna.
Oh well. Apologies to Muddy Waters Estate. No matter what.
I'll pull up the lyrics for it too. Now, when I was a young boy, at the age of five, my mother said,
I'm gonna be greatest man alive.
But now I'm a man.
But a man.
I made 21. When you believe me, honey. Having okay. lots of fun.
The song's got bad to the boom.
Spell it M.
I know.
A child. And
can I change my
spell
voice?
Mannish boy.
Yeah, yes, you can, only because it's Muddy Waters.
Okay, so I'm going to pick that one.
Fuck yeah, you are.
But that means the vote
goes down to two votes now.
That means that vote goes down to somebody whose mind isn't changed regardless, and that means Chancy gets to take a vote.
Nobody leaving here without singing the blues.
So yeah, I already knew Chancy's voting that one. But which way do I want to go is the question, and as much of a classic song as that Muddy Waters song is, I gotta give it to No Dignity because it's about replay for me, and I'd rather listen to that song over Mannish Boy.
I didn't give you rankings too. I'm sorry.
I don't need to hear Chancy's. I don't need to hear Chancy's theme song every day.
I didn't go yet.
Yes, you did.
Did I?
Oh, no. Bubble started it. You go.
Bubble started. Yeah.
Because surprise, I'm going No Dignity.
Yeah. Okay. Actually, I wouldn't be surprised, honestly. But
14 and 17, they're close.
But you're not next. See,
it's another one where if I saw them side by side, I'd go Mannish Boy. But ranking them,
you're not
next.
You're not next, so it doesn't matter. Yeah. Josh is next.
She's got classy style. No Dignity.
And Kasey, it's all tied up. Which way you want to go?
Damn. This is going to get interesting because I think that means it's going to be a fucking 3-3 tie. Muddy Waters.
Do we have anybody who's voting or watching live that maybe wants to give the final vote? Or
I mean, we have two people. We have two watchers right now. So we have two watchers right now. So if you guys want to comment and vote, your vote won't matter. But
Vito, you know what to do, man.
And then it's a permanent tie forever.
You have a friend out there named Vito.
Aaron, he has a roommate out there named Vito, but
they vote against everything.
Aaron, are you going with No Dignity actually, or are you going with Muddy Waters? I want to hear
Mannish Boy number 17, No Dignity number 14.
Oh, close. Ooh, okay.
Close.
Yeah. I used to hear Mannish Boy every day at a place in Cincinnati called Burbank's Real Barbecue.
Well, if Vito is watching, we are at a tiebreaker and we need someone in the comments to vote for either Mannish Boy by Muddy Waters or No Dignity by Blackstreet, featuring Dr. Dre.
First vote goes.
There we go. First vote goes. I think that's
all right. Let me type and ask.
I think Vito dropped in, dropped out. Chancy, like, fuck that matchup. But, all right. Well, time to go to my handy dandy nickel here. Chancy, call it.
Don't you have to assign heads and tails to something before you flip it?
I thought you said tails.
I'm going with tails.
No, it's whatever chance you voted for.
And what's heads and what's tails?
Whatever chance you voted for is tails.
Chance you voted for Muddy Waters, so that's tails. And it landed on the ground with heads up, so that means no Dignity's moving on.
No Dignity moves on.
It landed on the ground. It landed on the ground, so I didn't even catch it.
Do they land on the ground? I guess they do. The NFL does it that way.
So it landed on the ground, so I didn't even touch it to flip it over or anything, so you can't blame me.
It landed on its side, on the ridge, face up, vertically.
No, it did not. It did not, but that means that Cat Stevens will face Blackstreet in the next round. And the first half of round one is officially over at 1 hour and 9 minutes. Lovely.
We're boogieing.
It was
quicker toward the end.
Oh, yeah. But it's a little bit slower than last time. But I With this fucking playlist, I expected that.
I got a long story with everything.
Side round one, get started on Chancy, and it's only 13 years apart in the matchup, but it's a complete genre matchup. It's number 423, Chancy, Criminal by Fiona Apple from 97 versus number 406, Sucker MCs by Run DMC from 84.
One of these songs just narrowly missed my top five. One of these is number six. You got to guess which.
We'll find out soon enough.
I'm going to go with the controversial response and go, I'm going to say Criminal.
Well, I mean,
I got to spin around to the wine box.
Really, Munchkin? But I'm sure with what Casey does to you every night, she feels like Criminal.
The wine box. We already know that that's just, look at that. It's a prop. Of course it's going to be in a box because we can't actually see how thick it is because, you know, just feasting on the blood of...
Wait a minute. Bubbles wants to see how thick it is, Aaron.
I set myself up for that one.
You kind of did.
I got to set up an OnlyFans and she's got to pay.
Capitalism.
I can maybe get word of mouth from somebody.
Personally, on this one, I'm going to go with Sucker MCs because it is a classic rap track, and I can't fucking deny that. And, I mean, Criminal's a good song, though. That's another song that grew on me with this playlist over and over again. So, but still, Sucker MCs is a
classic. You didn't know that song before this?
Criminal? I think I've heard it in stores and shit, but I never actually listened to it.
That fucking video, though, for real.
That's wild.
In 97,
wild.
In 97, I was 9 years old in 97. I wouldn't have been watching anything Fiona Apple did. So, yeah. But
MTV?
My wife and daughter were stalking her in Whole Foods one time. So, like, following her down aisle dude, trying to act like they weren't
watching MTV. I didn't start watching MTV till like, the 2000s. So, yeah. But which way you want to go, Josh? Fiona Apple or Run DMC?
Sucker MCs
gets another vote. And Kasey.
As per the rest of the evening, I'll be voting with the gentleman hovering over my head.
I think you don't want your co-host to kick your ass, but...
I'm not afraid of her.
You say that now, but... Hey, Ron.
Until she pops in your freaking lobby. Well,
hey, first Ron, what was your ranking?
My wife thought that the word stalking was a bit harsh. She heard from the couch in the other room. So they were just observing aggressively.
Aggressively observing. I like that.
aggressively observing. Is that okay? They were looking in her shopping cart to see what she was eating.
Wait, would it be excessively frozen vegan observing food instead of aggressively? Because aggressively just sounds angry.
I know.
But excessive, it's just...
Excitedly?
Excitedly.
Enthusiastically?
Intently?
Intently? Curiously?
On this episode...
She's saying, oh my God, stop.
I was just getting ready to say something like that. That's hilarious.
Fiona Apple, Criminal. Number 31, Run DMC, Sucker MCs, Crush Groove 1. Criminal just narrowly missed the top five. It was that or Pearl Jam.
All right. Well, that means Criminal is ahead 3-2. Are you tying it up, Bubba, or are you going for Fiona Apple?
I'm going to go with Criminal on this one, actually.
No.
Not tying it up. No nickels today.
All you need is a good defense.
I mean, I am not mad at this at all. I'm not mad at this at all. Nor will I be mad at this next matchup, no matter what way it goes, as this one gets to get started off by, oh, look, me. Yay. And it's a, actually, it's a 1994 matchup, and it's number 422, Flavor in Your Ear Remix by Craig Mack, featuring Notorious B.I.G., LL Cool J, Busta Rhymes, and Rampage.
Now, hold on. Versus, is the remix the song on the Rolling Stone list, or is the original
the remix is the song on the Rolling Stone playlist, or I would have put the original.
I was wondering that while I listened.
On our playlist. Right. But Flavor in Your Ear Remix, featuring most of the biggest rappers of the 90s, early 90s at least, is facing number 405, Amor Prohibido by Selena from 94 as well. And I start this one off, and I gotta go with Flavor in Your Ear. Because, I mean, Selena's song actually grew on me throughout the last week, but I can't vote for a song I can't fully understand. I mean, my Spanish is pretty decent, so I can understand most of it, but I can't fully understand all of it, so I'm not going to vote for it. I mean, it's a beautiful song, but it's Flavor in Your Ear. I mean, it's LL Cool J and fucking Busta Rhymes, and I guess Biggie, I like Biggie better than Tupac, but I'm not a Biggie fan really at all either, but except for a couple songs. But I got to go with Flavor in Your Ear just for the people that are on it. But
Chancy's gone bloody asshole mode.
Yes, he has. But Josh, is it Flavor in Your Ear or is it Amor Prohibido?
I know zero Selena songs. Like every time I hear Selena, I think Jennifer Lopez. And I'm like,
the entire song's in Spanish. I will tell you that.
But zero of them. So Flavor in Your Ear and 90s and 2000s rap collaborations were amazing. So different styles with just on the same song and switching it up. Just Flavor in Your Ear.
Flavor in Your Ear gets another vote. And Kasey, I know you're ready to have a meltdown now because of your love for Selena, but which way you want to go?
Actually, I'm very indifferent when it comes to Selena's, but
I thought you loved the movie.
I enjoyed the movie, but I also will not be incurring the wrath of one Miss Amanda Kohlhofer, and I will be voting for Selena. Aaron, you can vote now.
It's a brand new Flavor in Your Ear. Got a brand new Flavor in Your Ear. Number 13 versus Amor Prohibido, number 33. It's in Spanish. I didn't know really a word of it. Sorry, Selena.
I mean, I know what Amor Prohibido means, and I know what a lot of the other words in there mean, but it's, I can't listen to a song and have my mind translate everything in one like list, in like a bunch of listens. Like it takes, I just write it all down.
Flavor in Your Ear and No Diggity were like the same era. They came out around the same time, I'd say.
Oh, so did a third rap song that's in this at some point. But Bubbles, is Flavor in Your Ear moving on, or are you going for Selena?
Flavor in Your Ear.
I'm
sorry. I am so not ethnic.
You can't hard R that.
Flavor in.
Well, that means that
you are ethnic. You're white.
That means that Craig Mack will be facing Fiona Apple in round two. But which way would you have gone, Chancy? What?
We lost him, man. He fell into the bloody asshole.
I said yep.
Oh, yepped her.
Which means Flavor in Your Ear wins 5-1. And the next matchup, it's only 9 years apart, and it gets started off by Josh. It's number 421, How Soon Is Now by the Smiths from 84, versus number 404, Rock and Roll All Night by Kiss from 1975.
Ah! Wanna rock and roll all night and party at the beep beep. Terrible. Yeah, Kiss. Kiss for sure.
And Kasey?
Yep.
Yep.
No moves. Yeah. And that brings up to Aaron. What do your rankings say for the Smiths versus Kiss?
I'm the sun and the air of a shyness that is criminally vulgar. It's the Smiths. My God. It's not even fucking close. Song still dope. No notes. That's what I wrote down.
And Bubbles, are you tying it up or are you going for a Kiss?
I motion to move Kiss forward in the bracket.
Nothing in particular.
Doesn't mean it's moving forward just yet, technically. But Chancy, how about you?
Chancy has taste.
Good, Chancy.
I'm going to go with I am the sun and I am the air.
You going with the Smiths? How soon is now?
Rap bastard.
And yeah. C.
But it's S-O-N and H-E-I-R. That's what makes it cool.
Well, see, these songs for me, as I am deciding on this kind of, well, deciding between a coin flip and Kiss winning, Kiss was one of the, that Rock and Roll Night was one of the first rock songs I ever heard, of course, like a lot of kids in the 90s. But I kind of fell in love with the Smiths song throughout the last week, and I think Rock and Roll Night is fucking is horribly overplayed. So I'm going to vote for the Smiths and let a coin flip decide this, because I don't want to fucking give Kiss the win free-handedly, at least.
Interesting choice.
So, Chancy, call it.
Too late.
I'll call it. Tails.
Heads.
There he is. Chancy, call it.
The asshole has returned.
Call it heads or tails, Chancy.
Tails.
Tails, I get head.
And tails wins it, which means the Josh Smiths wins. Move on.
What moves on?
I don't know. Josh gets head.
The Smiths.
I get tail. Tails, I get head. I win.
Well, fuck it. Hey, man.
I'll be back.
Yeah. You can turn the camera off.
Don't make me
we'll turn our heads.
But that means... Oh. This next matchup to get started by Kasey, and I'm sorry, Kasey, from the get-go on this one. It's 60s versus 80s. No, I'm really not, but it's 60s versus 80s. It's number 420. There you go, Aaron. California Dreamin' by the Mamas and Papas from 65 versus number 403, Ain't Nobody by Rufus and Chaka Chaka Khan from 1983.
Chaka Khan, Chaka Khan. If it was that song.
I think you're phoning
me. This time you pronounced Chaka Khan's name right.
It could
tell be me something good. If it was that song, too. No.
Ain't nobody.
Tell me. Tell me that you like it.
But Aaron, is it Rufus and Chaka Khan or the Mamas and Papas?
I got Rufus and Chaka. This isn't their best song. I got this at 26. California Dreamin' at 19. So I got the Mamas and the Papas going forward.
Ooh.
Mama Cass and lives.
Senator Amidala, I mean Bubbles. Where do you want to go?
She got to do some silly hair shit if she's going to be Amidala.
I am down to see that, Aaron. Thank you. I'm down to see that.
Ain't nobody.
Josh, just give me a good idea for cosplay night there, buddy. Senator Amidala, you could be Anakin Skywalker. Come on.
No, Princess Leia in the gold bikini.
He can do both. He's married. He can do both. There you go.
Why are you trying to navigate some technical issues?
Yeah.
Not a technical issue. But Chancy, is it Mamas and Papas or Rufus and Shaka Khan?
I'm going to go with the Mamas and the Papas.
All the leaves are brown and the sky is gray.
Damn you, which means that bastard.
It's coming down to me, and both of these songs are legendary. Both of these songs are fucking classics, without a doubt in my mind. I knew both these songs from the get-go before I even fucking had to play them. So, but I don't know why, but I mean, I think it's the bigger chick from Mamas and Papas that kind of turns me on. So I got to go California Dreaming because
going for Mama Cass.
Oh, the Mama Cass chubster factor gets me 100%. I'm a big W.
Chubbing you up. So,
nice. You ain't fucking kidding, dude. That album cover been killing me all week. So Mamas and Papas is getting my vote. But Josh, is it Mamas and Papas moving on, or is it a coin flip for Rufus and Chaka Chaka Khan?
Mamas and Papas. I said I wasn't going to lean into the mic, and there I was.
There you go. Do it.
It looks good. It looks like you're on trial.
Which
you're responding which to, Senator? Yes, sir.
Which means the Mamas and Papas will face the Smiths in the second round. But the next matchup gets started off by Aaron. And I'm actually kind of curious to see how he goes on this. It's a genre matchup and a 20-year difference almost. It's number 419, Fantasy by Mariah Carey from 95. Versus number 402, Lovely Day by Bill Withers from 77.
This is a slaughter. Lovely Day by a mile and a half. The note that he holds at the end of Lovely Day is 18 seconds long. It's one of the longest notes ever recorded by a human voice.
That's because no one ever recorded me coming, but yes, go on.
Yeah. And the Mariah Carey song, I liked it better when it was just the Tom Tom Club. She kind of took a great song and made it worse. So. That's it. Number 32, Fantasy. Number 10, Lovely Day.
All right. And Bubbles, is it Lovely Day or is it Fantasy? I mean, both can be with me, but take a pick.
Fantasy.
You're going to make it hard. You're going to make it hard. I swear to God. Chancy, which way are you going? I think I know, but I'm not.
I don't have any problems making things hard.
Oh, we are all well aware of this, Bubbles. We are all aware of this in this fucking competition we've been in for 3 months.
I also realize that I'm in the minority here.
What were the options again?
So I must.
Alpha
female being the only one here.
It's Bill Withers versus Mariah Carey. Lovely Day.
Yeah, I'm going Fantasy. Bill Withers.
He is the genius of love.
Which means Bill Withers is ahead at the moment. And it's coming down to me. And personally,
18 seconds long.
Personally, I can't hear Fantasy without thinking of Rush Hour when the little girl singing it in the car before she gets abducted. But Lovely Day is one of my favorite songs of all times. And I told my wife the other day, I'm like, if we actually had a real wedding, it would have been our wedding song. So, and there's an amazing American Dad episode in the second season that has that song in the beginning. So it's Lovely Day. For me, at least. But Josh, is Lovely Day moving on, or are you giving it to Mariah Carey? Like we all wish we could.
Lovely Day. Hi-yo. Lovely Day. Lovely Day. Lovely
Day. Good.
Lovely Day.
And Mariah Carey gets left in the dust. I mean,
I'm so disappointed about this. So I'm pretty sure I'm going to have to veto that coin flip decision with the heads here.
It's not a coin flip. It won 4-1.
I know this one wasn't, but I'm gonna have to veto the last last agreement.
I don't care.
The heads like tails like a head. She's vetoing that. I'm cut off.
Oh, okay. I don't care about that either. But It ain't me, so no sympathy. But Kasey, which way you want to go?
I would like to be nice, and I'll stay in the minority with the senator and vote for Mariah Carey. You're welcome, Senator. Oh, thank you.
It's a damn good song. If it was up against almost anything but Lovely Day, I might have voted for it. But it's Lovely Fucking Day by the great late Bill Withers. So Mariah Carey already has Christmas songs monopolized. She can keep those. So the next matchup, though, gets started by the Senator Bubbles. And it's a 60s versus 70s matchup. It's number 418, Green Onions by Booker T and the MGs from 62 versus number 401, Go Your Own Way by Fleetwood Mac from 77.
You can go your own way.
Go your own way.
Yes.
No, gotta go. Gotta
go. Chancelot.
Chancy.
Chancy, is Kasey doing unspeakable things to you right now? Not the Kasey on screen.
Yeah. I said yes.
He upped. Okay. So he went Fleetwood Mac.
A yes to which question, Chancy? Is
I think both. I think he upped her just so he can keep getting yupped.
Personally, I mean, Green Onions is an amazing song.
Fuck yeah.
It's in every heist movie, they play during the planning scene. But Go Your Own Way is a fucking incredible song, especially the fucking guitar at the end of it is so incredible. And I love the Gleeps, where they did that whole Rumors album on it, and they did Go Your Own Way at the end. So I will give it to Fleetwood Mac in this one. But Josh, which way are you going?
Go your own way.
And the song that is about Fleetwood Mac breaking up moves on, which I fucking love. It will face Bill Withers in a 1977 matchup in round two. But finish us off there, Kasey. Which way you? Actually, I'm not. No, finish us off.
I didn't go yet.
Where you want to go? I know you did. Yeah, Kasey. Which way you want to go?
Loving this matchup is the right thing to do, but I will definitely go my own way.
This box isn't a bad vintage. Trader Joe's Block Red Cabernet.
And Aaron, which way do you want to go?
Green Onions, numero dos. You thought it was number one earlier. It was
your I did.
Go Your Own Way, number 11. I want to say for Go Your Own Way, it's got a great groove in it. Mick Fleetwood's got this modified street fighting man thing going. It's top notch. The whole Rumors album, all the tension in the band. There's never been a crucible quite like that. But Green Onions is just iconic. It defines the Memphis soul sound. The original title was Funky Onions, but one of the band members' sisters thought that sounded too much like fucking onions, so they changed it to Green Onions. But that song is it's the shit, man. That is that a Hammond organ? That's the song, man.
I think they should have kept it Funky Onions. Like
I think so too, but. Green Onions was a hit.
I fucking hate onions. I can't even vote for onions.
Oh, no.
You don't eat onions at all?
I will eat onions like a motherfucker.
You're allergic? No onions. No onion.
Everything but onions.
But that means the next matchup.
Is it a taste or a gastrointestinal issue? Now I have to know. I got to dig deeper.
It's a taste. It's
definitely a taste.
It's definitely a taste thing.
Well,
I love onions, but they don't love me.
Well, that means that Chancy gets to start the next one, and it's a big 39 year difference, and it's Chancy. It's number 417.
Sounds like
Uptown Funk by Mark Ronson.
May September thing going here.
First featuring Bruno Mars from 2015 versus number 400, Station to Station by David Bowie.
I'm gonna go with Bowie.
Of course you would. I mean, for this matchup, Uptown Funk is one of those newer pop songs that actually can get behind. Also Glee related, but and David Bowie, I like some of his songs, but I never would call myself a David Bowie fan by any fucking means, because I don't think he's that great. I mean, he was what he could have been great if he became what Marilyn Manson became eventually. So,
do you live in a hut in the woods?
Dude, David Bowie is okay. He's had a few good songs, but
this is what I live with.
Station to station, you're talking about.
Okay, Chancy, are you okay? Because this, I don't know. Sometimes it seems abusive.
I need a support group.
Chancy is getting the support he deserves. He's getting the support he deserves, but
okay.
I personally am going to give it to Uptown Funk You Up, because as much as I fucking tried to fight that song at first and not like it when it first came out, it eventually just grew on me. And I mean, I'm not a Bruno Mars fan by any fucking means. I'm really not. But I mean, I think I'll Catch a Grenade for You is one of the stupidest fucking songs ever. But I will give it to Uptown Funk, because that makes you want to dance. Makes you want to shake your fucking ass. And Bubbles, if you want to do that, we'll get more viewers. But just saying. But Josh, which way you want to go? Uptown Funk or David Bowie?
You don't think I'll vote for it? You don't think I'll vote for it? You don't think I'll vote? Don't believe me, just watch. You know, I also claim to not be a Bruno Mars fan, but I end up liking almost everything he does. That song, I believe, is also in Little Big Planet, the Little Big Planet Sackman thing.
Sackboy or something.
Adventures of Sackboy. And just, I love that level. No More Planet. And just, I don't know how I keep falling in love with Bruno Mars stuff and claim to hate him so much. Like, but just faking it to make it.
You love him. You love Bruno Mars. You love the Hawaiian sensation that is Bruno. What about Bruno? Do we talk about Bruno?
We don't talk about Bruno here.
We talk about him on Mars.
But
in the Buffalo stance, yes.
You're going with Uptown Funk too there, Josh?
Uptown Funk.
Fuck no.
And
don't believe me, just watch. But
Kasey, which way are you going?
Uptown Funk You Up. Uptown Funk You Up.
I mean, I know some girls in Uptown that'll fuck you up. But
yeah, if it's girls, you know, I'm gonna take a very easy pass on that one.
But that brings it back up to Mr. Aaron.
It's not the side effects of the cocaine. I'm thinking that it must be love. So, Physical Graffiti by Led Zeppelin and Station to Station came out like a couple months apart. And people have pointed out that it's possible to discern in the song Station to Station a distinct flavor of the groove, tempo, and sense of building tension created by Kashmir on Physical Graffiti. And it totally does. I think he kind of, I wouldn't say ripped off, but ripped off the vibe of Kashmir in this. But it's a slow, slow build. And it's a great fucking song. It's like 10 minutes long. It's the first song of the Thin White Duke persona. And it's number 7 versus number 16, Uptown Funk. Hit your hallelujah, funk you up. Sorry.
See, I had a feeling that Aaron would actually find that song good. I had a feeling, but how can you not? It's just like one of those songs that makes everybody feel good. But
what, Station to Station or Uptown Funk?
Uptown Funk. Station to Station is kind of depressing. And but
number 16 is almost smack dab in the middle. That's where Uptown Funk ended up
for me. Oh, so you're going with Station to Station then?
Number 7, yes.
Okay, I misunderstood that. But Bubbles, Is Uptown Funk moving on, or are you going to stay Sensation for a coin flip?
David Bowie. Let me say it a little slower.
See, I really enjoy David Bowie, but I will say that I enjoy Bruno Mars more.
It's not even his song, though, is it? Technically, he's like a featured guest.
His song,
it's a Mark Ronson song.
Like, I have to agree with it. It is definitely one when it comes on, like the whole house, like is like stopping what it's doing to dance along with it. And it's definitely something that I can continue to listen to for years. And it kind of like makes me think, like, because here in Reno we have the Hot August Nights. And I feel like...
Are they a Neil Diamond cover band?
I also love the way I do that. Whenever I hear, "Don't believe me, just watch," I think especially, "Don't believe me, just watch."
No, there's a Neil Diamond double live album called Hot August Night, recorded at the Greek Theater in like 1972 or something. It's like legendary, where he's addressing the people that are watching in the trees out like past where you pay to get in. He's like, "Tree people, I love you." But that's not what they're based on. They're not a Neil Diamond cover band.
Well, I mean,
Hot August
Nights. It's not a Neil Diamond cover band. It's an event where like they have like older cars.
All
and
the
everything.
Oh, okay. It's an
cars
event.
Come out and everything. So it's a song that kind of feels like a classic to me. So like in the future, when they are trying to portray now, I could totally see that being classic, something super classic. So
there you go.
The future classic.
It's a future classic. Yeah.
The future classic, but it's going up against a classic.
Going up against a classic, but I'm looking towards the future. We don't go back to the past.
I mean, it's always a
Bowie's timeless, man.
I will say it's always a hot space. It's always a hot August night where Bubbles is, but
well, thank you,
Josh. Which way do you want to go on this? Oh wait, we finished that. We finished that fucking shit. What am I talking about?
That was the last one.
Yeah,
that was the finale. You're welcome.
Which means that I could start off the final playing match of the night to determine the last song to go into round one for the final match of round one, and it's a 70s versus 90s. It's number 415, "Enjoy the Silence" by Depeche Mode from 1990, versus number 399. That's right, folks. We're in the 300s for this one song. Number 399, "You Make Me Feel Mighty Real" by Sylvester from 1978. And fuck me, this is a tough one. This is really a tough one because.
Can you repeat two songs for me? I was daydreaming.
It's "Enjoy the Silence." It's "Enjoy the Silence." Enjoy the silence first. "You Make Me Feel Mighty Real."
It's not quite 8 p.m. here yet. "Enjoy the Silence" versus "You Make." Okay.
And personally, I love both these songs. I mean, I am not a Depeche Mode fan by any means, but the only song I know them by them is "Personal Jesus." But
Jeremy,
what
we are currently picking up a seventh person.
Oh,
all right.
No more coin flips. Motherfucking Amanda.
Hi, co-host.
Just got out of the car after a 17-hour drive. Jesus.
17-hour drive from fucking where?
It was like a 7-hour drive.
Seven-hour drive from where?
South Texas. San Antonio to Fort Worth. Shit show. Yeah.
Within one state, you drove 7 hours.
Okay. It took 14 to 15 hours to get across the entire state of Texas.
Texas is a fucking landmine, and since we declared war against North Korea,
I'll try to have my soothing voice for you, Amanda.
Thank you.
Amanda, we actually just started this matchup, and
okay.
I go first in this one. You'll go first in a couple, but
on my phone. Sorry, you guys.
It's number 415. "Enjoy the Silence" by Depeche Mode from 90, versus number 399, "You Make Me Feel Mighty Real" by Sylvester from 1978. And I'm not a Depeche Mode fan, so I'm going to vote for Sylvester because that song I like a fucking lot more. I mean, "Enjoy the Silence" is fucking amazing and hypnotic up to the silence part. Then I'm like, what the fuck is going on? Like, why is it silent for fucking a minute and a half straight? Like, what the fuck?
You got to enjoy it, dumbass.
Tell us how you really feel.
I don't enjoy the silence. I want music.
They gave you instructions. They were perfectly clear. It's up to you to follow them.
Well, the instructions
enjoy
are for re-reads.
The silence.
I don't enjoy the silence, but Josh, which way do you want to go?
I'm going to stick with the Pesh mode as well.
Enjoy the silence.
Well, it's not as well, but okay.
I thought you said the Pesh mode.
Oh, fuck no.
I'll go with the Pesh mode then. I'll start it off. Start the Pesh mode off.
There you go.
You make me feel mighty real is an amazing song from the 70s.
Well, you make me feel like a natural woman.
I'm sure I do, Kasey. Aaron, I'm sure I do. But Kasey, which way you want to go?
Yep.
And Aaron, is it Depeche Mode or Sylvester? Which one's higher in your rankings?
You know, it's Depeche Mode. I mean, number 20 versus Sylvester, number 28. Not my favorite Depeche Mode song by any stretch, but
I mean, it's no Personal Jesus, which I'm sure is innocent some other part in the future.
Personal Jesus is the best Depeche Mode song, if you ask me, yes.
But Amanda, is it Enjoy the Silence or You Make Personal Me Feel Mighty Real?
I really enjoy You Make Me Feel
Mighty Real.
Real. Yeah. I also had a gummy. Yes, I'm voting for Sylvester. That song's great.
Oh, she's pulling a Chancy.
That's an agreeable gummy you had. I can tell. I'm voting for Sylvester. That sounds great.
Hey, oh shit, dude! It's definitely it's still agreeable. She can't even sit up. She's like, I just gotta lay down for a minute.
I
just
wanna lay down. I wanna be on a diagonal. Fuck you, people.
Oh yeah,
fucking Texas.
But speaking of my man, actually, no, it's not your turn yet. Bubbles, which way you wanna go?
I'm gonna go with the Pesh mode. Did I say it right? I don't think
what
I said
Depeche
mode.
You've never said it before? You never heard it said on the radio? I don't think it's
Which means Depeche mode makes it in the first round. Well, I'm not sure it's going to make it past the first round, but we'll find out in a minute. Because that means that Josh gets to finish us out here. I mean, not Josh. We did finish it out. What the fuck?
No, Chancy gets to finish us off here. He hasn't gone
yet. Oh, true. Yeah.
Finish us off, Chancy.
Finish
Depeche
us off.
Mode.
Okay.
Depeche mode.
This is when the screens being with you and Josh on the same screen fucks me up.
We can switch it if you want, if it makes
sense. It's fine. But that means Depeche mode does move on to the first round like I already determined. And number 415, Depeche Mode, Enjoy the Silence from 90, is going to face a song that came out a year later. And it's going to get started off by Josh. And it's facing number 416, the last song in this bracket, Alive by Pearl Jam from 91.
Oh,
pop quiz. What was number 420 again?
Number 420.
Mama's in the Papas.
Mama's in the Papas.
Yep, Mama's in the
both.
Papas, California Dreaming.
Alive. Pearl Jam.
Is there something more she said? Of course there is.
And that brings it down to
it's the best Mr. song Kasey. About incest ever.
Mr. Kasey, is it Alive or Enjoy the Silence?
I mean, I literally should vote for Washington Grunge Rock since you uncultured swine voted Dave Grohl out in the first round.
Are you going to pick a middling?
These all fools voted instead. Co-host, these fools all voted Dave Grohl out in the first round.
Yeah. I did not.
I did.
It was against Rapper's Delight.
Yeah.
I wasn't mad about
Sorry,
it.
Sorry, Dave Grohl. Dave Grohl would vote for Rapper's Delight.
The Foo Fighters.
Alive.
No skin off his nose.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Foo Fighters. The
Foo Fighters. I love
you're more defensive about it than he is, man.
But Kasey, does that mean you're going with
Kasey's asleep? He fell asleep. No, there he is.
Alive.
Oh, you phone for a life. Okay. Caught me surprised a little bit, but which way do you want to go, Aaron? Is it Depeche Mode or Pearl Jam?
Pearl Jam number 5, Depeche Mode number 20. This is a blowout, man. It's seminal grunge track. It was first written when Stone Gossard was in Mother Love Bone, and Eddie Vedder wrote the lyrics, and he joined Mookie Blaylock, and they became Pearl Jam. Boom.
Does that mean you voted for Pearl Jam?
Yeah, it was number 5 versus number 20.
Okay.
Garage door's going up. That means
are the pops there?
That means my wife poured bleach to deal with the dog piss smell, but and my eyes are burning. So, Amanda, which way you want to go? Is it Depeche Mode or is it Pearl Jam?
I am like one of Pearl Jam's lowest level fans. Like, I am not a fan at all, but Alive is one of the few songs of theirs I actually enjoy, so I'll vote for that.
Which means Alive will move on and will face Uptown Funk in the second round.
Ooh.
But that means Bubbles. Which way are you going to go, Miss Senator?
For dexterity purposes, I am also going for Pearl Jam. Thank you.
And that brings it down to Chancy.
Man, fuck Eddie Vedder is all I have to say. Fuck him in his stupid, pretentious fucking ears.
Wow. Pretentious ears? What?
I don't know. I didn't want to say his mouth, but because that's just cliche. But you know what? Just fuck him right in the ear. Just fucking get it. But no, I'm not a fan of Eddie Vedder. Like, I don't know what it is. It's just, well, that I would confess to the Kennedy assassination if they played fucking Pearl Jam nonstop for like 26 hours.
Well, Chancy, one, now that we're at war with North Korea, that might happen. And two, like Violent J said, I could sing like Eddie Vedder, only better.
Yeah, okay, I guess. But yeah, I'm gonna go with Depeche Mode even though it lost.
Yeah, I mean, between these two songs, I honestly like both these songs like in the same level. So I'll give it to Depeche Mode too, just to give him 2 votes against the 5. But that means that round one is officially fucking over an hour and 51 Ooh. Minutes in. And I knew this was going to be a long one because it's a fucking amazing playlist. All I ever wanted, all I ever needed is here.